Welcome to the Engineering video series. This tutorial describes how to conduct inverse modeling in GeoStudio 2019. Inverse modeling is an important practice in both the science and engineering fields. The objective for inverse modeling is to find an optimal set of parameters that provide the minimum value of an objective function. In order to do this, the inverse modeling process must start with the results of a model already known, and then the causal factors that produced those results are calculated. Generally, this means that the inverse modeling process is formulated as an optimization problem using an objective automatic estimation procedure. Inverse modeling is also referred to as parameter estimation or parameter identification. Two of the industry standard inverse modeling software packages in geo-environmental engineering are PEST and UCODE, which include numerous tools to assist with the inverse modeling process. For the purpose of this video, the inverse modeling software package PEST is used to conduct an optimization of a previously defined GeoStudio file. Like UCODE, the PEST software package is model independent, which allows PEST to interact with a model through its own input and output files. This requires that instruction and configuration files are created prior to running PEST to ensure that PEST is able to find the desired parameters and calculate the objective function based on the result output from the model. The objective function calculates the difference between the observed and simulated model responses. In PEST and some other software, the objective function is defined as the sum of weighted least squares. PEST must be launched from a command line prompt. The instruction and configuration files must also be checked using the PEST tools via the command prompt prior to running the optimization process. In order for the input and output files to be accessed by PEST, the GeoStudio file must be in the XML file format. In this tutorial video, we will be discussing the setup of the accompanying example file called Multistep Outflow. It is highly recommended that the PEST website and manual are reviewed prior to conducting inverse modeling with GeoStudio. We will start with the GeoStudio file Multistep Outflow already open in GeoStudio 2019. This example considers a one-dimensional analysis based on a multi-step outflow experiment. Please refer to the associated example files to review the experiment setup and background information. We will quickly review all of the material properties and boundary conditions present within the file. Next, we will save the file type in an XML file format. Initially, we will try to save the new XML file in the same folder as the existing GSZ file. Instantly, we note the error that explains an XML file must be saved in an empty folder. We will return to the Save As window and create a new folder to house the XML file. For simplification, we will name the folder MSO. The warning then serves as a reminder that the new folder is meant for GeoStudio to use when solving and saving the file. Therefore, no other files should be added to the folder. Now that we have saved the file in the XML file format, we can go ahead and solve the analysis. Once the analysis is fully solved, we can review the result graphs that were created in the original GSZ file. In the XML file format, we will be able to use the results in these graphs within the optimization process of PEST by referring to their CSV file location in the results folders. Let's close GeoStudio and take a look at these folders prior to setting up PEST. We will go into the folder that contains all of the files downloaded from the Multi-Step Outflow Example webpage on the GeoSlope website. This includes the original GSED file, along with the instruction and configuration files required by PEST, saved as a zip file. For more information on these required files, please refer to the associated example document and the PEST website. First, we will extract the files so that they are saved within the same folder as the GSED file. This will make them available to PEST to run the inverse modeling process. Once extracted, we can next take a look at the GeoStudio files that will be used by PEST. If we click on the new folder that we created for the XML file, we will see the XML file along with the mesh file. The experiment folder was created by GeoStudio when we solved the analysis and holds the result files for each saved time step of the analysis. If we scroll down past all of the folders representing the saved time steps within the XML file, we will find the CSV files for the results graphs that were created in the original GSED file. These files will be called by PEST to calculate the objective function value during the optimization process. The PEST executable files must be downloaded from the PEST homepage. It is recommended to also review the documentation available on the PEST website prior to running the optimization process to ensure that the process is well understood. Once the files are downloaded, only a few of the executable files are required for this particular example. So we will move them into the folder where the GSED file and the instruction files are located. A BAT file has been included in the downloaded files from the Multi-Step Outflow Example webpage. We will open this file next using the Windows Notepad, but this file could also be opened using any text editor. The file location for the PEST executables and the XML file must be updated within the BAT file prior to running PEST. We will copy and paste the folder location and save the BAT file. For more information about running batch files in Command Prompt, please refer to the Solving with Batch Files using GeoCommand tutorial video. We will also need to update the file location in the configuration files. We will first open the PST file with the same text editor. Once the location is updated, we will save the file and then open the TPL file to update the last file location. Now that all of the files are ready, we will open the Command Prompt window. First, we need to enter the file location. Since the file location is still on my clipboard, I will use the paste command. Next, we will run the executables from PEST that will do a check of the instruction and configuration files to ensure that all of the files are set up correctly. In this case, we will first run pest check on the PST file. Next, we will check the TPL files using the temp check. Lastly, we will check the INS files using INS check. Once all of these checks pass with no errors, we are ready to start the optimization process. In the associated example file, the Shuffled Complex Evolution algorithm from the University of Arizona is being used to run the optimization process. To do this, we need to use the command as shown on the screen, as well as in the example document. Note, this optimization process can take a long time, so we will not wait for the process to finish in this video. Please refer to the example document for a discussion on the results of the optimization process and comparison with laboratory data. Thanks for watching and enjoy using GeoStudio 2019.